10:52 p.m.
Just remember, the 9-to-5 job you work, doing what you love, can sometimes be better than owning the place. Because when things have to get done, the boss has to stay to make it happen. 11 p.m. leaving the office. Self-awareness, people. This vlog should be called Reality. Okay, so tell me if this sounds familiar. You meet with a client, and then they say to you, okay, so how much would it cost to produce like a 30-second video for Instagram? Now, in general, your response is probably one of two things. It's boom, it's this much, or if you're like me, it's always, well, that's a really hard question to answer. See, no doubt about it, video production is a very, very difficult thing to be in because pricing in video production is extremely hard to do. If you're in video production, you know why I say that, and it's because there is not like a formula to every 30-second video only takes this long to shoot, to edit, to think about, to pre-produce, right? There's no formula to it. A 15-second video on Instagram could take 15 seconds to film, or it could take 5 months with 19 different writers, 6 different actors on 7 different continents. Right? Like, it could be all over the map. So how in the world do you price your cinematography accordingly? Honestly, I have not figured that out perfectly yet, but I'm trying. And here's kind of my thought process behind what goes into how I price things. Number one, I never ever give someone a quote in person on the spot when they randomly ask me that question. I don't give them the price because, number one, I don't feel like you should ever give someone a price right away. You should really get a feel for what their budget is. But more importantly, I don't give them a price because until I really have a clue what their video is actually all about and the thought process and the demographic and what goes into the filming and the editing and all that, I really don't know what it should cost because I don't know what work is involved yet. See, if you've been doing video production for any length of time, you know that no video is the same. No client is the same. Nothing about each video is the same. The client can know exactly what they want to do, or they need you to do the entire directing and designing and creating and thinking about it. The client can be local, or the client can be out of state. It's all over the map. Like, how do you figure this whole thing out? How do you figure pricing out? And then when you get into monthly things, like what we do with companies and retainers and all that. But here's a little bit about my process and how I kind of think about it. When a client comes to me for a video, most times in their head they already have an idea of what they think they want to do. So they may come and say the simple common things like most people, that I want a 30-second video or a 60-second video. They're naturally thinking those kind of things because in the days of commercials where you had limits on radio and television, you could either choose 15 seconds, 30 seconds, 60 seconds, right? You had to choose a time length. It's not like that anymore. You really can do things as long as you want because ads can be kind of as long as they want because people can skip them and they can be on any format they want, and they don't have the rules like they used to, but people still come to you with the same type of rules in their head, or they think that it should be as short as possible because no one has an attention span. It's all over the map. You see, the easy thing for me to do would just be to say a 30-second video costs $2,500, whatever, $5,000, $10,000, whatever your cost is. But here's what I've realized to be true. Because no video ever is exactly the same, no client should ever pay the same. You see, some people have this bad vision that like everyone should pay the same price and that no client should pay more than one client, and everyone, you should just have a flat rate for things and you should just maybe price it based on per minute of edited video. And I just don't agree with that whatsoever because of every situation being so different. There are clients that are harder to work with than others. Not necessarily like they're not friendly or they are friendly, or it's more of that they just might have different ideas, different demands, different processes that they have to go through to get a video approved. So should those two people pay the same for a 30-second edit when that's all they got? I don't think so whatsoever. See, I don't think it makes sense for me to average out an overall price of what the average cost is, because is there an average in video production? I don't think it is, because to be honest, as you get better in what you do, you spend more time doing the editing, more time doing the filming. Just because you get better at what you do doesn't mean it takes you less time. It sometimes takes you more time because now the lighting that you had that wasn't so ideal, that used to be okay with you because you didn't know lighting, now you know lighting and it takes longer. And the basic edits that you used to do are just too basic. Now you need to be more advanced. There's always gonna be factors that keep changing pricing and keep changing pricing. And so you really have to just think about what should your cost look like. See, I also think it's incredibly important to realize that your costs don't need to be what someone else's costs are as well. It doesn't really matter what the competition charges or what your market charges, because realistically it has to make sense for you as a business. If you're a one-man operation, your costs are much lower than somebody else's. If you're a humongous operation, your costs are much different than others. So you may produce the exact same quality video with the exact same amount of time, with the exact same resources, the exact same camera as someone that is like a one-man operation. Your cost may be three times more because that's just the reality. That's why the one-man shop can sometimes win, because of price alone. But you can't really concern yourself with that, because your costs are your costs. And regardless whether you want to be able to charge cheaper or not, you might not be able to. And honestly, I pay zero attention to what anyone else is charging. And some people may think that that's a bad decision, to not really pay attention to who's around you and what they're charging. But to be honest, it doesn't really change what I do. If tomorrow I found out that I am the cheapest company in the entire world, I wouldn't necessarily raise my rates tomorrow, because maybe I'm at a price point that makes sense for me. Also, if I found out tomorrow that I'm the most expensive company in my area by five times, well, I also still wouldn't change it, because I'd say we're still doing well with business and we're still getting more business and my pricing is just where I decide. And I'm not saying I'm right, because I never have ever said on this channel that I'm right. I just like to tell you what I'm thinking. But I have so many people constantly that have been asking me, like, how do you properly price commercial video production? And the answer is, I can't tell you that, because I can't tell you what you should charge, because I don't know anything about your life, your business, your area, your demographic, your equipment, your overhead, your experience, your goals in life. Your goals in life change what you charge. Like, there are so many factors that go into this whole thing. So here's maybe the only takeaway that I feel like would make sense for me to tell you, and that is this. This may sound like weird advice, but I think that you should just charge whatever you want. And especially if you're a small business or you're a one-man operation, decide whatever the heck you want to charge and charge it. And then if you feel like you should charge more, charge more. And then keep charging more and keep charging more and keep charging more. If you get zero work whatsoever, you might want to charge less. Maybe you're too expensive. But if you're in a spot where you feel like you're charging what your time is worth, you're making a living, you're liking what you do, and you are growing, then why does it matter what other people are charging? Just charge what makes sense for you and worry about you. What makes sense to you?